I see.
Captain! Is so much incredible and with so much greater speed than boring old balloons.
Huh? So you've flown in a hot air balloon before then, have you?
Mm-hmm. But it was a cramped and unspacious experience. Such gaieties as this were entirely not possible.
Serevna, you're too much perilous.
It's truly essential to travel at such excessive altitudes.
Give me a break. Don't tell me you're scared of heights, too.
Fear not, Kirill. I have devised the perfect strategy to combat your fear of high places. First, you must take the hand of a fair maiden and bask in the joy this brings. Then, and only
look,
then...
Look, everyone! Huh? Is that it over there?
Ah, indeed! The incomparable castle of Arbor, and above it, Yggdrasil, symbol and protector of our mighty realm!
This is bad. The World Tree. My goodness, it's... Okay.
What?
Promise to help as much as I can.
Yikes! You wouldn't stand a chance if you fell from all the way up here.
Yep. Anyone without wings needs to watch their step. Monsters included.
Monsters? But of course! Friends, we must use this to our advantage.
Prodigious numbers, and they assail us both from above and below.
Whatever their number, we have to hurry. We must reach Yggdrasil's crown before it is too late.
Ha!
waves form odd little shafts, don't they? Makes it rather hard to see which way to go. Also makes it rather hard to see the blooming monsters. Don't get ambushed, you lot.
Perhaps tight ropes will swiften our journeys between branches. Kirill, you would enjoy, yes?
I beg, Sarivna, you comprehend my great terror of high places. Do not taunt me so.
Ha ha ha! Do not quake and quiver so, poor baby Kirill. I shall hold your hand.
Desert slash!
Cool, blimey! They're on the branches, they're in the skies, bleeding everywhere. I can't keep up with this.
The crown is still a way away. We can't let them get the better of us just yet.
Prodigious numbers, and they assail us both from above and below.
As long as we win, that's all that matters.
them a lesson they won't forget.
I've been waiting for a chance to break my all-time monster slaying record. Here goes nothing.
Tsarevna, you are too much perilous. Please to promise me you will not act with such abandon.
Fiend's assault rages outside also. Can we really take on such numbers?
Well, we can't exactly leave them to it, can we? We've got to do something.
Something about Yggdrasil reminds me of a certain mysterious tree back in our world.
An overgrown twig? That's like comparing a bleeding great oak tree to a poplar.
Cold vision.
What's that you say? Something about you being a bleeding great oaf with no imagination?
And that's one less to worry.
All right, let's serve you.
Witness to my might.
Lizard slash.
Fool. Who in heaven?
Vicious. Be careful, everyone.
This ends right now.
Percy. Good boy.
Gotcha.
As long as we win, that's all that matters.
Yggdrasil's crown is beyond this door.
Okay, let's go, go, go! I'm going first this time!
Oh, Bluey! Crikey, what the X2's problem? Well, this don't look too clever. Old Brickface over there ain't gonna let us through, is he? We're not gonna get in with him on the door.
If the Guardian will not allow us to pass, then we must pass through the Guardian. Oi, oi, let's get stuck in!
No one mentioned anything about a gatekeeper. You don't think this means...
Alas, I fear that it might. Yggdrasil's crown may already have been infiltrated.
We can't have that. The altar's our only hope. We need to get past this thing and get in there.
It is as they say. The most toughest bow requires sharpest axe.
We must avoid to panic. Peruse for an opening and give to him thunderous what for.
We'll be seeing of him. All right, come on. Last one in, Zah!
Not so fast. Something strange is afoot with our sparring partner.
Huh. Itching for another round, huh? Don't mind if I do.
Nothing.
beaten him into submission. Now is our chance.
You know what? I think we might be able to send him flying. Literally.
And see what happens, shall we?
Youngus!
Gotcha! Bianca! Nera!
Monster. There'll be a way to beat it, just you wait and see. Bianca is right. If we keep fighting our hardest, we're bound to happen upon something eventually. Told you I'd have him.
So, my dear Lightlings, at last we meet again.
Wait, isn't that him? You know, the one from the arena in Colosseum.
It sure is. I've been looking forward to this.
A moment. Ah, but of course. The self-satisfied swordsman. So, despite your protestations to the contrary, you were with the Lightlings all along.
Nope, but I signed up with them. Figured they'd lead me straight to you, and they sure didn't disappoint. Time to pick up where we left off. Let's go!
Please do desist. Prior to combat, let us make inquiries of him and determine his identity.
Seconded. And I would know what business he has with us Lightlings.
Do not fret, little ones. I mean to tell you everything. To begin, it seems only right that I introduce myself. I am Velasco. Last and greatest king of the Children of the Night.
The Children of the Night? Isla spoke of a force. I take it your people stand against the Children of the Light.
So, you have learned something of the world's true nature since last we met. If so, you must have also learned of the centuries of oppression my people have suffered at the hands of your forebears. A long, long time ago, under the guidance of the goddess, your noble ancestors conspired to attack the father of the Children of Night, the Great Black Dragon. By their treachery, my master was robbed of his strength and sealed away against his will using the power of Yggdrasil, the World Tree. After this, the world was flooded with light, and only light. And monsters began to forget their eons-old enmity with man, becoming little better than sniveling lapdogs.
What? Are you saying that monsters are meant to attack humans? I refuse to believe it. It's not in their nature.
How wrong you are. It was not just the monsters your kind corrupted, my dear. The very fabric of the world itself was warped. Warped by the unjust actions of the Children of Light. I crave but one thing, that the natural balance be restored. That the darkness be allowed to retake its rightful place
Stop
in the
him.
World.
He's going to hurl that thing at Yggdrasil.
Not if I can help it.
No, wait!
My dear Lightlings, you make it too easy.
What? Heaven!
Come on! Break! Free!
This altar is a thing most sacred. Only the Children of Night and Light may approach it. What better place than this to set my trap? Witness the power of the Circle of Night. The only way to plunge Yggdrasil into darkness is to plunge the Children of Light into darkness also. Down you go. To the blackest depths of night.
No, I won't let you do that. Hmm? It's time for the slime to shine!
What in? An amusing interlude, but just a little too far-fetched. As if a heel slime would bear the Circle of Light. What joy! What pleasure! What sweet satisfaction! Now, Lightlings, Let your minds and your bodies drink in the darkness and relinquish your hold over the World Tree. It will not take long for the blackness to seep down and gain a stranglehold on Yggdrasil's roots. And when it does, that detestable seal will be broken. And my master,
my god, the great black dragon shall rise again!
Listen. You must promise me. Promise me. That you will never let him win.
Well, there ain't no turning back. What do we do now? Second too soon. All right, everybody. I think it's time for us to go.
From this place? But surely you do not intend to jump?
It's all right. There'll be no need for anything so dramatic as that.
So upset.
Can you blame them?
They've just seen someone they hold dear wrenched unfairly from them.
If only I hadn't just run in like that without thinking. Then he wouldn't have...
This is no time to be blaming yourself. If anyone is at fault here, it is I.
Your Majesty.
In this world of ours, there live certain stout-hearted souls, warriors, charged with the sacred task of protecting the children of the light, guardians. And I, your humble king, count myself among their number. Being such, it has ever been my sworn duty to protect the two of you, come what may.
But you're the king, and we're just soldiers. You're saying you were supposed to protect us?
Just so. All the rulers of my line have held this selfsame honor. And yet, alas, I was unequal to the task. I failed in my duty, and one of my charges came to harm. No! Ma! I shall dwell no more on such woes! Not while a glimmer of hope yet remains!
What? Are you saying there might be a way to bring him back to us?
I know not, but there can be no harm in seeking counsel. The goddess may yet provide.
When you say the goddess, would I be right in thinking you mean the same goddess who sealed away the dark dragon?
Do me a lemon. What chance you got of speaking to a bleeding goddess?
There is a place in this wondrous world of ours where the children of light may go to hear her speak. A sacred tower known as the Pinnacle of Light. I have never visited the Hallowed Spire myself, but legends tell that at its very top stands an altar wherein the goddess dwells.
So if we go there, we might be able to save Yggdrasil and help bring him back as well.
You must journey thither, and I, for one, shall journey with you.
And I, noble friend, I will adhere to you until our journey's very end, as shall we all. Well, is this not so, friends?
Hey.
Truly, we are blessed! Never were there more dependable companions!
Then it's settled. To the pinnacle of light!